we want to do today. I'm going to start off with a greeting until we get some of the others. But in Thanksgiving, we'll start with the meaning, the background of Thanksgiving. Thanksgiving is a national holiday celebrated in the United States, Canada, St. Lucia, and Liberia. It began as a day of giving thanks and sacrifice for the blessings of the harvest and of the preceding year. Germany and Japan also have a similarly named holiday. In 1621, the Plymouth colonists and the native Indians there shared a autumn harvest feast. And that was to acknowledge all of the good crops and everything that had gone on. But it still wasn't. Back on in 1789, George Washington finally issued the first Thanksgiving proclamation by the national government of the United States. And he called upon Americans to express gratitude for the happy conclusion to the country's war of independence and a successful ratification to the United States. Thanksgiving really started off as a religious holiday. And it started off with with all of our like presidents or any of our people, just showing that they really did give thanks to God. They wanted it known that we recognize God and for all the things that he did. But it wasn't until in 1863 that the national holiday was really established as the fourth Sunday of the fourth Thursday of the month of November. But it's a grand, grand day. And I'm just going to start by introducing our choir members, of our new DeSoto Golden Voices. We'll start with our director, Mr. Larry Willis. He's our director of pianists. We have our first drummer is Mr. Dwight Coleman. Drummer there who is so wonderful, Miss Aaron Brown. We have guitarist, Mr. Ron Thomas. On tambourine, we have Miss Barbara Galloway. And on congos, we have Mr. Chris Line, who is also our choir founder. The soloist for today will be Ron Thomas, Catherine Evans, and yours truly, Tilly Harris. So we're just going to have a good time. We want you to enjoy. We want to be grateful. The main thing is being grateful. An attitude of gratitude means so much. You know, just being grateful makes you feel bad. And God is so good. We're thanking him not for just the things that go well. We're thanking him whether nothing goes well in our life because we know he is the one who controls everything. And we just want to thank him for that. We just want to thank him so much. And what we're going to do now is have our first two selections by our Golden Voices Choir. Thank you very much. Thank you. the Holy Spirit that has to go on. Right now, we're going to have a praise dance by Ms. Shirley McCarty. And you come up and you're just going to be so blessed. because we know who's in charge. Every day is a day of thanksgiving. God's been so good to me. Every day he's blessing me. These are the lyrics to a very popular song. Every year on Thanksgiving Day, we celebrate with gusto and joy, food and football. And the next day, we're shopping. Next day, with shopping and Pepto-Bismol. The word Thanksgiving is a compound word. Thanks and giving. What does it mean? How should we reflect the true meaning? 2 Corinthians 4:15 reads thus, "All this is for your benefits, so that the grace that is reaching more and more people may cause thanksgiving to overflow to the glory of God." The short version is easy. Thanks means to express gratitude. Giving means to share one's blessings to enrich others. Another way to look at it is to pay it forward. The simplest way to define pay it forward is that when someone does something for you, instead of paying that person back directly, you pass it on to another person instead. In today's climate of payback and getting even, with attitudes of "I've got mine, you get yours," or "I've got mine and I'll get yours too," this may seem outdated. Is it? Let's go back to the 2nd century to recall a Greek fable. A slave named Androcles once escaped from his master and fled to the forest. As he was wandering about there, he came upon a lion lying down, moaning and groaning. At first he turned to flee, but finding that the lion did not pursue him, he turned back and went up to him. As he came near, the lion put out his paw, which was all swollen and bleeding, and Androcles found that a huge thorn had got into it, causing all pain. He pulled out the thorn and bound up the paw of the lion, who was soon able to rise and lift the hand of Androcles. In gratitude, the lion became tame towards him and henceforth shared his cage with the slave. As it would have it, after 3 years, Androcles becomes homesick and craves a return to civilization, but is soon imprisoned as a fugitive slave and sent to Rome. There he is condemned to be devoured by wild animals in the Circus Maximus. The emperor and his court came to see the spectacle. The lion had been kept without food for several days. Androcles was led to the middle of the arena. Soon the lion was let loose from the den and rushed pounding and roaring towards his victim. But as soon as he came near to Androcles, he recognized his food. He fawned upon him, licked his hand like a friendly dog. The emperor, surprised at this, summoned Androcles to him and told him the whole story. Whereupon the slave was pardoned and freed, and the lion let loose to his native forest. Because gratitude is the sign of noble souls. Jumping forward to the 21st century, in a 2000 film directed by Mimi Leder, that starred Haley Joel Osment, was released in theaters entitled "Pay It Forward." Mr. Osment plays an 11-year-old Trevor McKinney, a latchkey kid living in Las Vegas. His social studies teacher gives the class an extra credit do a good deed for three people, something they can't do for themselves, and then he will ask each one of them to pay it forward by doing similar difficulty favors for three others. As the story goes, his deed has a tripling effect and catches the attention of a journalist. It grows into a movement and becomes a phenomenon. Any random act of kindness can cause a positive ripple, affecting a possible. Can cause a positive ripple effect, restoring our faith in the love and compassion of the human spirit. We especially experienced this during COVID-19 pandemic. A pandemic or tragic event is not a requirement for kindness. Don't wait or hesitate. Insert a quarter in a parking meter that's about to expire. Hold the door open, carry a bag or lunch tray for a fellow senior. These are all acts of kindness. The return is not immediate, but somewhere down the road, you will remember the act of kindness when it returns a hundredfold in a different way, because someone else also paid it forward. 2 Corinthians chapter 9:11 states, "You will be enriched in every way so that you can be generous on every occasion. And through us, your generosity will result in thanksgiving to God." Christ paid it forward on a hill far away. And we are yet reaping the benefits today.
Yeah.
Every day is a day.
Yeah.
Thank you. Yeah.
On a Monday,
yeah, yeah.
The song said, "Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is what?
Good.
He is good all the time and all the time."
Thank you. make it the next morning. My son came after me. I raised four sons and a daughter. God taken all three of them and left my baby son. So that's who I am with now. God has really been good to me. But if someone here, I would want her, come up, baby. Yes.
Open our eyes, and we will look yet in the land of the living. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you as we slept, we slumbered, oh Lord. You kept your death angels at bay. You kept those that would have done harm to us and our families, oh Lord, you kept them at bay. So we come right now to say we thank you, Lord. Oh Lord, we thank you that you sit high and you look low. Thank you, our Heavenly Father, because we realize from everlasting to everlasting that you are still God, that you are God all by yourself. And now, Lord, as we come today, we come thanking you for the gift of life, your darling Son, Jesus Christ, who died for our sins, but he didn't stay dead because in 3 days he rose, and he had all power in heaven and earth in his divine hand. Thank you, O Lord, for that wonderful name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus, O Lord, every knee shall bow, every tongue shall confess of things in heaven and things on this earth and things underneath this earth, that you are Lord of all is all to the glory of God the Father. And now, Lord, we come right now lifting up our honorable prayer to you today, Lord. We ask, O Lord, that you build a hedge of protection around her. Help, O Lord, in making decisions for this wonderful city. We just ask right now, Lord, that you just keep her in your care. And we pray, our Heavenly Father, for every minister and every church door that's open in your name, our Heavenly Father. Bless all civic leaders here in this, O Lord, and surround this city. We love you right now. And, O Lord, we ask you to bless every household that's represented. We thank you, O Lord. We realize, O Lord, that we can't do nothing without you, but through Christ Jesus, who strengthens all things are possible. And now, Lord, we pray for the sick and the shut in throughout this land. We pray for the bereaved right now. Lord, touch what touch is needed. Realize, O Lord, that one day is all going to be said and done on this side. Lord, lead us in that hour and take us over to the other side. And over there, O Lord, we realize we'll be careful to give you the praises, Lord. We'll be able to praise you throughout all eternity. Father, we ask these and all those blessings in the name of Jesus Christ. We pray and ask.